Drawing Turtwig, Chimchar, and Piplup is easier than you think, and I'm going to show you exactly how you can do it, no matter your skill level. Hello, wonderful people! It's Genevieve, and my goal here on this channel is to teach you all about illustration and design. So if you're new, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of the weekly videos and so that you can join our wonderful creative community. And with that said, grab your drawing tools and let's get started. You can follow this tutorial along using any drawing tool of your choice, even pencil and paper will totally work for this since we're basically just drawing lines. I'm personally going to be using an app on the iPad Pro called Procreate. Now, if you're working in a digital app software, make sure that you find a canvas size that works for your own project requirements. For reference, these are the dimensions that I will be using. If you're not exactly sure how to pick a canvas size, I have a video in which I explain everything you need to know in order to make your decision, so I'll link that below. And in this video, we're going to practice breaking down characters and basic shapes, which is a really, really important skill in illustration. So even if you're not necessarily into drawing Pokémons, this tutorial is super, super helpful to develop that skill that is crucial in illustration in general. That being said, here we're going to draw the three starters that are in Diamond and Pearl, so Turtwig, Chimchar, and Piplup. And if you want to only draw one of them, I have the chapters in the video so you can just navigate until that one. We're going to start with Turtwig though, and we're going to have the example here on the left, and I'm going to show you how to break down the character very simply and then how to kind of reconstruct it so that it looks good. And here we're going to start with a rough sketch. So for that you can pick a light gray, and if you're drawing with pencil and paper, just make sure you don't press super hard on your pencil and you should be good. And in terms of brushes, in Procreate you can use the HB pencil in the sketching panel. Otherwise, if you have my illustration bundle, which is really not essential for this video, you can pick the sketching brush. Now here really just pick a brush that you know you're comfortable with, because we're just sketching, so it doesn't really matter. And we're going to start by roughly placing the ground, so just a horizontal line, as well as two circles that are kind of stacked like a snowman that is falling on the side. So the two circles should be roughly the same size. And that really is the base of our character here. Now, all we have to do is add the other elements. So we're going to start by making the bottom part of the top circle, which is going to be the head, a little bit more flat. So you can extend the sides and then add a flat bottom. So it's going to look like a bell shape as opposed to a circle. You can then draw a kind of a party hat, I guess, on the top of the head, as well as two leaves to recreate this little sprout that we have on top of our Turtwig. And here, don't worry, if you have a bunch of lines, that's totally okay, we're just doing a rough sketch. And we're gonna add the legs at this point, which is just going to be a bunch of ovals. So one is going to be on the far left side of the bottom circle, one is gonna be pretty much in the middle, and the other one is going to be on the far right. Now we need four legs, so the other one is kind of hidden in the back, it's going to be touching the oval that is in the middle of the circle. Now this is really starting to look like Turtwig. We're going to add the kind of decoration elements. So for that, go ahead and draw a vertical line that separates the face as well as a horizontal line. So this is what I call the plus sign, and this helps us place the elements on the face. So it shows the direction of the head, basically. We're also going to be able to add the shell. So for that, you can just draw a slightly curved line that starts above the back leg and touches the head. So something a little bit like this. And you can just draw then the thickness of the shell. And don't forget there's a little vertical line on the shell as well, so something a little bit like this. Now we're going to refine our shapes a little bit more so that they look like Turtwig. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to lift up the belly, because right now the circle is touching the ground, which is not quite accurate. So you're just going to take your curve and lift it up from the ground a little bit, kind of like that. We're also going to make the bottom of the legs flat. So right now it's just this oval, so you're going to make the bottom flat as opposed to rounded. And once that is done, we are going to fix the jaw shape as well. So you can see here, the jaw is a bit more round on the left side and it kind of pokes out a little bit. So you're just going to draw this on your sketch. And then you can kind of bring it in and draw the actual jaw shape that covers the face. So you have this curve at the top, and then towards the front you have kind of a V shape, like a little divot, like this. I guess that's a mouth. I don't know. It's quite cute. I'm not sure how to describe it. But yeah, it's just a kind of a V in the front of the head. You can also go and refine the shape of the head itself. You can see the left side is a little bit more flat than the right side. The right side is really, really nicely curved. And you can also go back in and draw a big, big oval for the eyes. So this oval should be pretty much in line with the little party hat sprout that we have. And with that oval, you're going to draw two more. So one is going to be for the iris, and then the other one is going to be the pupil. And in the pupil, if you notice at the top, there's kind of a little gap that you're going to leave white for just a speckle of light. Now we're almost done with the rough sketch. You can also just divide the leaves in two with this little line like that. And then we're going to be ready to clean up our sketch. So here we're going to be doing some line art. In order to do line art, I really recommend, well, at least if you're working in digital art software, that you go ahead and lower this Turtwig sketch layer that we have until you can just barely see it. So maybe 40% or something like that. And then above it, you're going to create a new layer, rename it to Turtwig Line Art. And on this layer, you're going to draw in black. Now, if you're using pencil and paper, you could use, for example, like a pen to really ink your drawing. And if you're just working with pencils, that's why you wanted to make sure that your rough sketch you press really, really lightly so that you can now go back and press hard on your pencil. If you're working with Procreate, you can use a bunch of different brushes. You can explore in the inking panel, picking the studio pen or something like that. Or in the sketching panel, you could go and pick the 6B pencil if you want a bit more texture. I'm going to be using the outline brush for my illustration bundle, but seriously here, just pick a brush that you know you're comfortable with because you want to be able to create nice, smooth outlines. And here, really, all we're going to do is we're going to find our line. So we're going to pick the line that we want to use from all the different lines that we created when we were doing the rough sketch. So it's really a case here of just going over and finding which line to use and making sure that we're super, super, super happy with them. So the rough sketch, we're really not focusing on making it look good. We're just focusing on trying to figure out the different elements, the proportions, and stuff like that. Now here with the line art, though, we do want to make sure that our lines are super clean and exactly where we want them to be, because that's what we're going to use later to color in our character. And in terms of line art, one pro tip that I would have for you is try to avoid erasing. I know that seems really scary, especially if you're new to drawing and illustration. You're much better at, well, I mean, you cannot do that on pencil and paper, you're going to need to erase. But if you're working on the digital art software, you're much better to undo if you draw a line that you don't like and try again, as opposed to erasing a little section and starting over just that section. There are a few reasons for that. Believe it or not, it saves some time overall. To undo instead of erasing. But the most important reason is that when you erase a little section and try to draw it again, you basically break the flow of the line. And you're gonna end up with illustrations that don't have as much movement or don't look quite as coherent. So it's much better for these two reasons to just undo and redo. And the first few times you do that, it might be really, really stressful and difficult, but it's a really good thing to get used to. Try to not use the eraser. And you can see here, I use it a little bit to kind of erase the lines that are poking out, but I don't really use it to erase big sections of the drawing. I just undo if I don't like the line that I'm drawing. So I'm gonna stop talking here. I'm gonna let you focus on doing your line art, but I'm gonna keep the video playing in the background if you want to use mine as a reference. I'm gonna speed it up a little bit, and then I'm gonna meet in the next step. Now here, don't forget to add the little elements or details, I should say, on the legs. So the front legs are going to have this kind of M on it, and then the back legs are going to have a triangle. And you're probably going to notice I forgot the W at the top of the head where the sprout connects, so you might want to do it now. I'm going to do it in the coloring phase. I'm going to fix my mistake. So once you have your line art, you can go ahead and hide your sketch. If you're working with pencil and paper and you inked your drawing, you could erase the sketch now. And if you see that anything is wrong, like for example, I'm noticing that this leg just isn't long enough. It just doesn't work. it's not in line with the other ones. Make sure that you fix your mistakes at this stage before coloring, because otherwise it's going to be just a bit more time consuming to fix later. So make sure that you're really, really happy with your line art before moving on. And in the next stage, when we move on to coloring, I'm going to show you how to very, very quickly color it in. Okay, so this Chimchar little guy is a little bit more tricky than Turtwig because the basic shapes, there are more of them, but we're gonna do it. So if you're working in digital art software, go ahead and create a new layer, rename it to Chimchar Sketch, and we are going to sketch the basic shape. So here again, super rough sketch, and for that you're gonna use either a gray color, or if you're working in pencil and paper, just make sure you press super, super lightly on your pencil. You can use in the sketching panel if you're working with Procreate the ATP pencil. I'm going to be going with my sketching brush that comes with the Ultimate Illustration Bundle. The brush here doesn't matter, just make sure you're comfortable with it because we're going to be sketching, we're not going to see it in the final result. And we're going to start by roughly mapping out the ground as well as two sections that are the same size. So you're just sketching a horizontal line for the ground, then measuring kind of two sections here, stacked on top of each other. It doesn't need to be exactly the same size, like don't bring out your ruler. And then you're gonna roughly draw a circle to fill in the top section. So again here, your circle really doesn't need to be like a perfect circle. Just roughly draw something that looks like a round shape and that's more than enough. You're also going to be drawing a bean shape for the body. So it doesn't quite touch the ground, it's a little bit lifted. And we're going to divide this bottom section here in two, so just draw a horizontal line roughly in the middle. It really doesn't need to be precise. Again, no ruler here. And we're going to draw two ovals for the thighs that are touching this line. So they're attached to the body, of course, and they're also touching the line. So something a little bit like this. And notice the angle is kind of different, they're pointing outwards. You're then going to divide the bottom section in half again and draw two little ovals, this time pointing in a different direction for the shin. And dividing this new bottom section that you just created in half again. And then you're gonna be drawing two more ovals facing in the opposite direction from the previous ones, and these are gonna be the base for the feet. So make sure you peek at the example here to make sure that your legs are in the right angle and everything, but it's just a bunch of ovals for now. We don't need to be any more precise than that. We're also going to add the lines for the direction of the head, so a slightly curved vertical line in the middle, and then a slightly curved horizontal line roughly in the middle as well. At this stage, you can go ahead and tweak the shape of the head, so you can see the shape of the head is a little bit more extended towards the bottom, so there's a bit more of a jaw that is pointy as opposed to just a circle, so you can draw that here. And you can draw two very thin long ovals on the side of the head for the ears. You can also draw, I guess for now, just a like a cone on top of the head, like almost like a shark fin. We're gonna refine the shape later, but for now you just want to roughly map it out. And you can also roughly map out the arms, so for that just super thin, curvy ovals are gonna work. And you can roughly align them with the line that you used as the top of the thighs. So it's not necessarily exactly it, like you can see the arm on the right is a bit higher than that line, but it's still a helpful guide. For now, the hands, we're just going to draw some ovals, so nothing more precise than that. And you're also going to be drawing a cone on the backside of your character. Later, we're going to refine this to turn it into this kind of a flame tail that Chimchar has. So at this stage, we can go back in and start adding some of the details. We have the basic structure. So the first detail we're going to add is kind of this hairline, I guess. So you're going to be drawing a few triangles, a big, big one, and the point of this one is going to align with your facial plus sign, and then two smaller ones on the side. You can also add little ovals in the ears and refine this, I guess, like ice cream shape on the top of the head. And you're going to then be able to go back in your head, draw big ovals aligned on the horizontal middle line. This is kind of a extra big shape around the eyes, so make sure that you make them bigger than you think. And you're gonna notice that the bottom part is flat. So here you might want to lift the hairline a little bit if, like me, you made it too low, so you have a lot of space for your eye shapes. Now within these eye shapes, you're going to draw three more ovals, and notice here that the ovals are not centered in the eye shape, they're touching the middle, like they're pointing towards the center of the face. We're also going to refine the shape of the head, so we're going to draw this kind of a little bump, like a U shape, that connects with the outside edges of the two eyes, and later we're going to use that as the mouth, I guess that is. You can also draw little dots for the nostrils, as well as tiny little lines towards the inside top of the eyes for eyebrows, maybe. There's also a spiral on the front of the chest, and then you can connect that spiral with the top of the thigh and maybe tweak the shape of the body so it's a little bit rounder at the bottom. Now we're also going to add 3 ovals in the front of the feet, so these are going to become the toes later. And at this stage, you're going to be able to connect everything. So right now we have a bunch of separate shapes, but if you just go over them with one line, you're going to connect them all to create the basic outline of your character. It really doesn't need to be precise here. Again, we're just drawing a rough sketch, and the next step we're going to go over and create the outlines for the line art. Now, I know fingers can be a little bit scary, but here we're just going to be drawing a bunch of ovals for now. So you're going to draw the thumb and then 4 long ovals for the other fingers. The thumb is going to be kind of quite far away from the other ones, as you can see in the example here. And you're going to do that on both hands. And with this rough sketch, we're able to move on to the line art, because right now this is super messy. We're going to create something cleaner. I personally liked to lower the opacity of my rough sketch around 40% until you can just barely see it, and then create a new layer above it for the line art. If you're working with pencil and paper, you either press really hard at this stage with your pencil, or you would pick a pen or like an inking kind of situation and ink over your sketch. If you're working with digital software, you're just going to set your color to black and picking either in the sketching panel the 6B pencil if you want to have a little bit of texture in your outlines. Otherwise, you can go in the inking panel picking something like the technical pen or the studio pen or any other brush that you know you're comfortable with. I'm going to move on to using the outlines brush from the illustration bundle. And here, same like we did for Turtwig, all we're going to do is we're going to find our line. So across all the different lines that we've sketched for the rough sketch, we're going to go and try to figure out which one we're actually going to use for the line art and later for the color as well. So this stage is not really complicated because we've already mapped out everything, but you need to really make sure you take all the time you need in order to get a super, super clean line for outlines. And here you're going to notice, that's what I was talking about when I was doing the Turtwig example, but since you might just be doing Chimchar, I'm going to say it again. Here you might notice that I'm not really erasing. If I have a little bit of a line that is overlapping like here, I might go ahead and erase that, but I'm not really erasing any parts of my curves. If I draw a line that I don't like, I just undo it and redo it. For a few reasons, that would be a better thing to do in general. The first reason is that it does save some time to undo and redraw as opposed to erasing a little section and trying to redraw that section. Overall, believe it or not, it is quicker, quite quicker actually. But the main reason is that when you erase a little section and try to redraw it, it's going to be really, really hard to try and match the same curve and have something that flows well. And if you want to have illustrations that look professional and have a lot of movement in them, that flow is super, super important. So you're much better trying to draw as long as the lines as you can and try to not erase and draw little sections. So just go over all of your lines in order to get a super clean line art. I'm going to stop talking, let you focus on this step. I'm going to speed up the video, but I'm going to keep it in the background so you can use mine as a reference, and we're going to meet in the next step. When you have your line art, feel free to go ahead and hide the base sketch layer if you're working in digital art software. If you're working on pencil and paper, you would go ahead and erase the pencil. And notice if anything is weird. So for example, here I have another leg. I had a leg in Turtwig as well that was weird, but I have one here that is just not long enough. So you can use, for example, the selection tool in Procreate, setting it to freehand, to go ahead and select the leg, and then you can use the arrow tool, setting it to distort, to extend it a little bit. So you could redraw it if you want, or you could resize it a little bit. Now, when you're resizing your outlines and your line arts, you need to really make sure that you're not doing too much of a resize like this. I did not have to stretch it too much, but if you had to really, really change the shape or the size, you would notice that your pixel starts stretching and it doesn't look quite as clean, which for a line art, we don't really want that. So use this technique only if you have a little bit of a stretch to do, otherwise go ahead, erase and restart, that's totally fine. Awesome, and with that, we're ready for the Piplup sketch, which is going to be much, much, much easier than the Chimchar one. It's just a bunch of circles. So go ahead and create a new layer if you're working on digital art software. Rename it to Piplup sketch. Otherwise, if you're working with pencil and paper, make sure that, again, you're not pressing hard at all on your pencil. You need to have a very light touch. You're going to pick a light gray color and a brush that you know you're comfortable with for this sketch. So if you're working in Procreate, in the sketching panel, the HB pencil would be super good for that. Otherwise, if you have my illustration bundle, we're going to pick the sketching brush. Now we're going to start by simply mapping down the horizontal line for the ground, as well as two sections, just like we did for Chimchar. The top section we're going to fill in with a circle, and you're going to notice this circle is a little bit bigger than the top section, so it goes down a little bit. And we're going to draw a smaller circle in the bottom section. So the smaller circle, the top, it's the middle line, and then the bottom doesn't quite hit the bottom line, so there's a little bit of a gap there. Once you have that, that's really the base for your Piplup. We're just going to add the other elements, like the arms and everything. So for the arms, well, the wings, I guess, you're just going to draw two ovals like this, and a third oval on the right side, which is going to be, I don't know what it is on the back, but like, a decoration on the back of the Piplup. You're also going to draw two smaller ovals for the legs or feet. And we are going to do the famous plus sign on the head. So just marking the direction of the head. So just a vertical curved line and a horizontal curved line. Piplup also has this, I guess, bib kind of shape. So you're going to draw a super curved W in the front of the body. And for the beak, you're going to draw an oval right at the bottom of your plus signs. You're also going to draw two big ovals for the eyes, and these are going to be aligned on the horizontal line that you have in the middle of the face. You're also going to circle around these eyes with a big, big, big oval. So both eyes like that. And then you're going to draw a W between these big ovals. So we're just drawing some facial details here. We're also going to be adding two circles on the belly. I don't know what it is, just a decoration, I guess, as well as two little spikes, well, kind of rounded spikes on the back of the decoration, and maybe adding a little bit more detail, so like the little line on the beak, and maybe the inside of the eye as well, so just a dark oval in the middle of the initial oval. Seriously, Piplup is quite easy. You can see there's not much more to it. So once you have your rough sketch, once more, we're going to move on to the line art. So feel free to lower the opacity of your base sketch layer and create a new layer above it for your line art. Here, if you're working with digital art software, go ahead and pick black. If you're working with pencil and paper, you could either pick a pen or draw really, really hard with your pencil. For the brush, you could go in the sketching panel using the 6B pencil, or if you want a smoother line, you could go in the inking panel with the technical pen or the studio pen. I'm going to work with the outlines brush from my ultimate illustration bundle. And here again, super simple step, we are just going to find the lines we want to use. So right now in the rough sketch, we created a bunch of lines because we were mostly worried about proportions and general, you know, look of everything and where everything is going to be positioned. But now we want to find one line for every element and just draw this one line as smoothly as we can. And I'm going to repeat it one last time here at this stage. Try not to use the eraser. If you draw a line that you don't like, especially the head, is really hard because it's a circle essentially. Instead of erasing a little section, just undo and redo the entire line or redo the entire section. You're going to get something that has a much more movement, and it's just a better flow in general, and it's going to affect the look of your illustration. If you erase little sections, you tend to get something that is a bit more static or has kind of a jagged edge, and that's not necessarily the best look. So you're much better undoing and redoing your line until you're happy with it. Once more, I'm gonna stop talking, let you focus, but I'm gonna keep the video in the background if you want to use my example as your reference. I'm gonna speed up the video though a little bit, and then we are going to meet in the next step. And with that, it is time for the secret password. So if you've watched this fine video, please leave a comment with which one of these three starter Pokemon is your favorite. Is it Turtwig? Is it Chimchar? Is it Piplup? I think mine, I would have to go with Turtwig. And if you're new on the channel, you might be like, what's the deal with a secret password? Well, it does a few things. One of them is it gives me a lot of insight into how to edit and paste my videos better, which helps me to create better tutorials for you guys, which is what we all want. And it's also really cool because you guys know me, you see my face in the intro, you hear my voice throughout the entire video, but I have no idea who you guys are. And whenever you leave a comment, I get to see sometimes your name, sometimes your face, and it's just really cool to see who's part of the creative community that we're building here on this channel. So just leave a comment with your favorite of the three starters, and we're gonna keep going. Now that we have super nice clean line arts, we're going to be ready to add the colors very, very quickly. So we're going to start with a Turtwig, but it's going to be the same technique for all of them. So we're going to create a new layer, put it right below the line art layer, and rename this one to color. Now going back and selecting the Turtwig line art layer, we're going to apply it as a reference. So if you just tap on it in Procreate, you're going to have the reference option. It's not going to be the same in all the general art softwares, but there's a workaround that I'm going to show you. And I made a color palette, you can download it if you want, it is totally free, I will link it in the description below. And in Procreate, you can add it just by clicking on the plus at the top and then selecting New from File, and you're going to be able to import it. I highly recommend though, if you want to practice picking colors, that you do that. So the color palette can be super, super quick, but it's a good practice to try and train your eye to do it yourself. So all you're going to do for Procreate is you're going to take the color at the top right and drag it onto the shape that you want to fill in. And you're going to see, even if you're drawing on a separate layer that is not the outline or the line art, I should say, since we're using the reference option on the line art layer, it's going to make it look like we're basically dragging and dropping the colors within the shapes of the line art. So we're going to do that with all of the colors, and we might need to adjust the threshold if you're working on Procreate at least. And to do that, you just hold your pencil on the screen and you move it from left to right or right to left until you find the moment right before the color fills in the entire canvas. So that way you get to fill in as much as your shape as possible. Now, if you're not working in Procreate, if you're working in a digital art software that is different, you might need to fill in within the line art itself. So you might not have a reference option. And the tool that you want to use is probably going to look like a little paint bucket. So you're just going to fill in straight into your line art. That's totally okay. That being said, it's really cool with Procreate having this reference option because it allows us to keep our line art separate from the colors. That way we can edit the colors really, really quickly and easily. And we also get a chance of keeping our line art clean if we want to change it later down the road. And don't forget to draw the little white speckle in the eye. You can't fill it in this one because it's not outlined, so don't forget to do it. And I'm going to fix the mistake that I was telling you about when I was drawing the line art, this little W shape on the top of the head. I'm just going to add that real quick right now and then fill it in with the brown. So you can see that coloring your characters once you have a super clean line art takes 2.5 seconds. It's super quick and easy. So for now, we're going to leave it as is, but later we're going to come back and shade it just further down the road in the video. For now, we're going to go ahead and color Chimchar. And here we're going to use the exact same technique, but just different colors. So we're going to create a new layer right below the line art, rename this layer to color, and we're going to apply the line art layer as a reference. Again, if you don't have Procreate, you're just going to have to fill in within the line art layer itself. Now, once you have that, you can go and on your color layer, just color drop the colors. So here Chimchar is mostly a bunch of super bright oranges and cream colors. So just follow along my example. Again, if you want to use the color palette, you totally can. It is free and it is linked in the description below. But I highly encourage you to train your eye to try and pick the colors yourself. That's really, really, really good practice for when you're creating your own characters or your own illustrations. And same technique with Piplup as well. So we're just going to create a new layer right below the line art, rename it to color, and set the line art layer to reference. Again, if you're drawing in a different art software that is not Procreate, you're going to need to drop your color directly on the line art layer. Otherwise, if you try to just create a separate layer underneath, it's just gonna fill in the entire canvas. So make sure that you keep that in mind. And for the color palette, once more, it is totally free. You can download it in the description below, but I encourage you to try and pick the colors yourself. That's really super good practice. So we're going to color in this Piplup and then we're going to start shading our characters. We're going to talk about the general concept of how to shade characters quite quickly and easily. Okay, so let's bring our characters to life with some really nice shading and just bright lights. So for that, we're going to start by creating a layer. It's just a scrap layer, so you don't need to rename it or anything. And you can pick whatever color, because we're just going to draw the light source. So for that, you can draw a circle, pretend it's the sun, and draw a bunch of rays that cover your character. So here, you can put the light source wherever you want. I'm just going to put it on the top right. So once you have your light source mapped out, we're going to be ready to start drawing the shadows. So for that, create a new layer above the color layer and below the line art. Rename it to shadows. And we are going to tap on this layer to open the menu, and we're going to apply the layer as a clipping mask. Now you're going to see, now everything we draw on the shadows layer is going to stay within the colors. So that's super helpful. We're also going to be using the blending mode linear burn. And for now, we're going to set the opacity at around 50%, but we can always come back and tweak it later. In terms of color, you can pick whatever you want for your shadows, but just try to avoid using a neutral gray or black because your shadows are going to look muddy if you do that. I personally like to use a gray that has a little bit of purple in it, but again, you can experiment with different colors. For the brush, you can stick with the 6B pencil and the sketching panel. I'm personally going to be using the basic texture brush from my illustration bundle. You could also use the shader. Here, honestly, again, it's just a question of picking a brush that you know you're comfortable with. I like those options because they have a little bit of texture, and the 6B pencil that comes with Procreate, super good for that as well. And if you're using a different software, just pick a brush that has charcoal in the name and you should be good. And we're going to start with cast shadows. So for that, all you have to do is start from your light source, follow the ray, and whenever the ray hits a body part that is overlapping a different one, then you would draw a shadow next to it. So you're basically seeing here, for example, the head is casting a shadow on the body is casting a shadow on the legs, and so forth. So just following your rays, and whenever you hit the body part, drawing a shadow behind it. So we have our cast shadows now, which is great, but if we're following the rays here, for example, over the head, we can see that since it's curving away, at one point the light is not going to be reaching this far. So we're also going to be creating what we call form shadows. So form shadows tend to have softer edges than cast shadows because they're just created when the light cannot reach a part of the character that is curving away from the light source. So these form shadows are going to be mostly on the left side of every different body part of your character, or just the left side in general. So here we're going to really, really roughly place them, and later we're going to blend them. And if you want to just copy what I'm doing, by all means, please go ahead. It's a tutorial, and if you're just learning, that's totally okay. But if you want to practice placing shadow, that's a really, really nice excuse to do it here on these Pokémons. Once you've roughly mapped out your shadows, by all means, feel free to hide the sketch for the light source. It's going to allow you to just clearly see what you've drawn so far and make any adjustments as needed. And you can also play with opacity until you get something that you like more. So this is going to depend on the color you picked for your shadows, so just experiment. And we are going to blend our form shadows. So for that, if you're working in Procreate, you can pick the stucco brush in the painting panel. It has a really nice subtle texture. Otherwise, if you are working a different software, the blending tool, usually the smudge tool, it's quite a basic tool, so you would be able to find it in most software, and usually it has this little finger icon. So just find a finger icon in your software and it should be a blending tool. And you can set any brush that you want. I like a brush that has a little bit of texture so that we don't create super, super soft gradients in the shadows. That's not necessarily the goal. I like to have a little bit more grit, but honestly, here you can pick whatever brush you want because we're just blending. It doesn't matter a whole lot. And here, make sure that you only blend the edges of your form shadows, so the shadows that are created with the light not being able to reach a part that is curved away. And you're going to want to keep the edges of your cast shadows a little bit harder. They don't have to be super, super crisp, but you want to create some contrast within your shadows, so form shadows would be softer, and then cast shadow would be harder. We're also going to be adding a shadow on the ground so that our character doesn't look like it's floating in the middle of nowhere. So for that, you can create a new layer below the color layer and rename it to ground shadow. So in this ground shadow, you're just going to use the blending mode linear burn again, although right now we're on white, so it doesn't matter, but if you add a colored background, that would help. And with the same brush and same color, you can just quickly brush your shadow. Now, if you're working with coloring pencil, all you have to do to shade is pick a darker version of the color you're trying to shade and draw on top. So it's, you know, not super hard. Here you would probably be working with forest green and a like dark chocolate brown, maybe a kind of an orange to go over your yellow. We're also going to create some lights. So for that, create a new layer below the line art but above the shadow. Rename it to lights. Use the blending mode add and set the opacity to around 50%. And you're going to set your layer as a clipping mask as well. For the color for the light, I like to go with a super, super bright orange color. It looks like the sun. And in terms of brushes, you could stick with the 6B pencil or go back to the outline brush. Basically, you just want a brush that has a little bit of texture to it, but is a bit more precise. So a charcoal brush would work as well. Now, for highlights, there are 10 billion techniques that you could use. I like to do what I call outlining the outlines. It's super simple and it really makes the character pop. And if we just reactivate here the light source and going back on the light layer to paint, we're going to be able to just outline the outlines, so the line art, whenever the ray hits a body part. So for example here, the ray is hitting the head on the right, so we're just going to outline that. And also adding these little outline highlights wherever you want to reinforce the separation between different elements. So it's really not a realistic way of drawing lights, but it's quite a simple technique. I guess it's part of my style now. But yeah, it just really helps the character pop. It takes a few seconds and it makes a big difference. And you're going to notice here for the Pokémons as well, I'm drawing this highlight in the bottom part of the eye just to bring out the color a little bit more. So that's something you can do as well. You can also add some extra shiny lines on different parts of your character that are made with shinier material, if that makes sense. I know it's not like it's not made of material, but like for example here, I'm imagining that the jaw is super, super shiny, so I'm just adding some extra little shiny lines like this. And maybe, I don't know, maybe the top of the legs are super shiny as well. So you can just add little dots and little lines wherever you want to reinforce the shininess. So this shading technique can be used for anything. So I'm not going to repeat everything. If you want to, you know, learn how to do shading and you haven't watched Turtwig, I highly recommend you check it out because I explain everything in details. But here I'm still going to have my video of me shading Chimchar and Piplup in the background a little bit faster so you can use it as a reference for the placement of your shadows. But again, I'm not going to re-explain the technique. Otherwise, it's going to take 20 billion years for no reason. So feel free to, you know, shade on your own, follow along if you want, copy what I'm doing. All these options are fine. This is a tutorial, we're just trying to learn. So whatever way you learn the best, this is what I encourage you to do. And here's the last little guy, Piplup. In case you did not watch the shading for Chimchar and Turtwig, I'm not going to repeat all the steps because this is a basic technique that works for everything, and I explained it in details in the Turtwig one, so you could go back and check Turtwig if you want more information. Otherwise, I'm going to have my shading example here for Piplup in the background. I'm going to speed up the video, but you can use it as a reference for where to place your own shadows if you want. Now, one thing to note for Piplup, if in the color you did not fill in white, you're gonna need to do it if you want to add shadows, otherwise it's just not going to show through. So you can just go back to your color layer, fill in the white, and then start adding your shadows. And one thing you can do on Piplup as well is going back on your color layer and adding a darker blue at the top of the eyes. I think it just helps ground the look a little bit because otherwise it's kind of almost scary. So just an extra little step you can do here for this little character. And if you enjoyed this video and want to learn how to draw more cute characters, I highly recommend you check out this playlist in which I'm going to teach you exactly that. But before you leave, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any of the weekly videos I post every Tuesday and Saturday. Then click on the link right here, and I'll meet you there!